I feel like I just need to take a break from
I
it.
don't.
Moment, I feel like I'm so exhausted to compose myself, lay out new strategies, lay out new plans for this journey. Beautiful people, welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to Motivational Brenda. This is the channel where you get all the life lessons, life motivations, life inspiration that will make sure that you never give up in life. Lately, I've been thinking a lot about the future of this channel, but let me start by introducing you all. So, if you've seen this for the first time, please hit that red button so that you can subscribe. And also hit the bell so that you get notified every time I post any new video. For the returning subscribers, I really appreciate you all because basically you are the ones who have been working with me since I started this channel in last year, around this time, November. So I think you're just my support system that has been there for me all this time. Yeah. So I really appreciate you. So guys, I don't know what you're expecting to see from the title of this video. I'm quitting YouTube. So there are things that people don't tell you, and those minor things that YouTubers will always hide from you, whether they're friends, whether they're people that are always around you, they'll not tell you the truth. So there are things that I didn't know at first while I started, but along the way I've come to learn them, and I felt like maybe I should tell somebody about them. Yeah. So first of all, YouTubing, or not just YouTubing, basically, content creation is not easy. You know, for me, I used to see my friends asking people to subscribe to their channels, posting videos every day, video after video. And I was like, wow, this seems like it's so much fun. And I was like, why not give it a shot? I also started YouTubing. So, but along the way, I came to realize that it's not that easy. Like, my people, content creation is not that easy, because basically for you to succeed as a content creator, you also have to be consistent in your posting. Yeah, so, and you see that consistency demands a lot of time. It's so time consuming. And you see, like for me personally, since I started this journey, my time has been so squeezed. I know I've lost so many friends because there are people who will not understand that you're busy. Because like for me, a normal schedule for me, when I wake up, first of all, I have to report at work. I do my work. At the same time, thank God COVID came and now we work from home. So I have to balance between being a parent and being an employee somewhere. So you see, it's not that easy because my work demands a lot of time and concentration, because if you just lose concentration even for 1 minute, you might end up causing a lot of error in your work. Then I also have to give my kid the attention. You see, for kids don't understand that you are working from home. They don't know that as long as they're seeing you there, you are the parent. They don't care whether you're working or whether you're working for somebody else. They demand the attention from you. Then there's YouTube. I have to make sure that I create videos for you guys and make sure they're presentable so that you can also enjoy. And I also have to go an extra mile to try and get you the right content, the content that you love, you know. So like balancing between the three has been so tough. So most of the time I end up not having enough time for other people. Most people think that I just ignore their texts. Most people think that Nilet may be Capride Kamekam because I'm on YouTube or something like that. So some people assume that I just ignore them on purpose. And you see, it has cost me some friends. You know, I feel so bad because I'm one person that values friends a lot. I feel so bad when I lose even a single friend. So no one ever told me that when you start content creation, your time will be so squeezed, you know. Then along the way, I've come to realize that it demands a lot of patience. You know, YouTube is not as in, let me just say YouTube, because I'm here a lot. I'm on YouTube a lot. Other sites, I just go there for fun or just to hang out. But for YouTube, I'm here for, as in, this is my passion, you know. For YouTube, you always upload videos, create content with the hope that one day your channel will blow up. Every day you create any video, you're always like, is this going to be the one? Is this going to be the one that is going to bring me the success that I'm always praying for? every day. Now you see, it brings that sense of uncertainty because you're not really sure when your channel is going to start performing very well. Like you see, for other people, those big YouTubers or some of those people that they have already established a good foot in YouTube, they don't have to struggle to get the views. Like for me, if I post any video, I have to let my subscribers know that I have uploaded a video. Then I also have to go an extra mile of sharing my links to other social medias, to Facebook, to Instagram, to TikTok, everywhere, so that I can get the views. But you see, every time I do that, I'm always like, God, when is my day coming? When am I going to stop doing all this so that I can only focus on creating content for people? I just upload a video and that is it. I don't have to go looking for people, asking them to come watch my videos. You know, it's also tiresome. So sometimes I feel like it exhausts me a lot. You know, that third reason why I'm considering quitting, it's because, let me say, it's so discouraging when you take all the time that you have, you create a video, you edit it, you give it that best flavor. Then after posting it, you don't get any views, you don't get any comments, there are no likes, probably some few dislikes. It just takes all the motivation away. Then you're left there wondering, should I continue doing this? Should I continue living this? So, you know, so for me, actually, I've been thinking about this for a while because, as I've said before, YouTube has taken a lot of my time. I've lost some friends. It also creates anxiety. Like, I've always been on the anxiety roll from day one because you want to impress your viewers. You want to make sure that your viewers are always engaged with your content so that you don't lose any, you know, losing even a single sub is so painful. It's so painful. And you see, every time you lose a subscriber, you just feel like, this person no longer likes my content. Why is this person leaving me? You know, so it also hurts you in some way. Yeah, so guys, given the four facts, I feel like I just need to take a break from YouTube. Not necessarily permanently, but just for some time to compose myself, lay out new strategies, lay out new plans for this channel, lay out as in just new strategies and the things that I want to see happening on this channel. Like of late, I don't know if you've noticed, I've been making advertisements and promotions for people, for products, for businesses. And you see, I do that for free because I want to try something new for people. And and the reason why I'm advertising for free is because I just want to appreciate the people that have grown with me. You know, growing from zero subscribers to 2,056 is not a small feat. And if somebody has been able to stay loyal to me for all that time, I don't see any harm in advertising their products, their products and businesses for them for free for the time being. So if you have anything that you want to showcase to new people, to reach out to new markets, you let me know. My email is on my description and also my phone number. You can WhatsApp me so that we can have a conversation about the same. So this is it, guys. I'm going to take a break for some time. It may be weeks, it may be months, but I'll be back when I start feeling re-energized once again, because at the moment, I feel like I'm so exhausted. I think a break will help. So I'm going to take a break for some time. And once I'm back, I'll come back with some great content for you guys. So keep on subscribing, like my videos. Help me to get to 2,100. I don't want a lot of subscribers for the time being. Let's start by getting to 2,100 subscribers, of which we're just about 44 subscribers away. So why don't we get there, guys? And if you are a content creator, I would love to also hear about your story. What are the things that other YouTubers never told you about content creation or about YouTubing? Whether they're the challenges, whether they are motivational factors, nobody ever told you, but along the way you've come to learn them by yourself, by experience. I would also love to know your experience. I will also want to know that I'm not the only one who's feeling exhausted at the moment. Yeah, so let me know in the comment section. And guys, I'll see you once I come back. Till the next video, guys. Bye-bye.